Alright guys, here is the reason why I have not made a layout update yet. I've been waiting on this thing right here to come in. I ordered it about 2 weeks ago, and it just came in today, and I was expecting it to come in last week so I can make an update on it during last week, but unfortunately it didn't, but it's here now. And it needs a lot of work, and I plan on doing a lot of work to it. So, like I said, it'll be fun. It'll be real nice when it's done. And so here it is. It's a Burlington Northern SD40-2. It's the Atheron Blue Box, but it's a dummy unit. I recently bought that Atheron SD40 with the electromotive paint scheme, and it runs good, but it doesn't run good with other locomotives like my Kato's and stuff. So I decided to get a dummy unit right here to run with it. But yeah, number 6784. It has a bunch of handrails that I need to install, horns, all that crap. These are Blue Box snow plows, and here's a Details Bless snow plow. So you can see it's the same exact snow plow, only it actually has holes in it. So most likely I'll be installing this one, but I don't know, we might see, I might put this black one on it, we'll see. But my plan for this is to actually make this a leash unit. Okay guys, here's my layout update. I just got done telling you about my new BN SD40, and it's not done, but I got the graphics on, the decals and some handrails, and it looks really good right now, weathered it and stuff. So here it is, running with my electromotive. The Furyx. I'll show you better details on it later, but just running with that one, and it runs pretty good. I'm gonna add some weights to it, make it run a little better, and it'll look good though. Unfortunately, it did not come with all of the details that were needed, like the handrails. It didn't come with those long handrails. But luckily I had some spare, and I tried to put them on, but these little clips that you put on, the metal clips that you put on the handrails, are crap and they don't work right. So I'm going to order some Atheron plastic handrails for it. I did put metal ones on the front up there. See on the front and on the sides right there. But I need sidings in the back. So once I get those in, then I'll finish putting the handrails on. But so far I think it looks really good with the Furyx patch. It's just lightly weathered right now. And I really like it. Looks good. But here's my layout update, and not much has changed on it. Just a little bit of work doing this up here, working on the bridge area, some mountain area stuff. What I did was I kit bashed my coaling mine, made it smaller, and this goes in there, and what I wanted to do was put that right here and have it cross the tracks, but I don't think I'm going to do that anymore. I might, we'll see. But pretty much my idea is to build retaining walls all the way up along this to the bridge, and then have the mountain up here, and this will be more retaining walls obviously, and I'll get one more piece of bridge just like this to put right about here, and the rest will be road. So that'll be cool. And my plan for the bridge is to get two of those and put them there. And I plan to put a chain link fence all the way across it. As you guys, if you've seen it going down the highway, they always have those chain link fences that are curved up a little bit at the top. They go down through it, and then they leave little rust streaks from the metal rusting and running down with the water. So that's my plan, is to do something like that. So that should be pretty cool when I get those. I've started painting a little bit over here. My engine yard. Not really much has changed though. I mean, a little bit of scenery over here. That's about it really. I mean, I went out and got some dirt from my four-wheeler track. So I got a bunch of dirt that I'll start doing stuff with. So that'll be pretty cool. Some projects I've been working on. This is my Southern Pacific Hopper with the Fred light in the back. And I'm just doing some light weathering on that. As you can see the difference. That's brand new. And this is just light coating. Also, I've been working on this BN gondola. A little bit of graffiti. Not finished. Has this custom load. Looks really good. It's removable. It's very nice. That one's not done yet. Here's the other side. Just a little bit of rust. Not too much yet. But it looks really good. Has Katie's metal wheels. So it runs real nice. This is another one I just got along with my BN engine. It's a MD&W high cube boxcar. And it's a ENC shops kit that you have to put together. And basically all I've done so far is put this bottom piece on. It snaps right in. And then you have to put the coupler boxes on and screw them in, all that stuff. And it comes with those cheap plastic wheels. So I got Atherogenesis high cube boxcar wheels and put them on this. So that's really nice looking, real nice trucks. And I have to glue the roof on, which goes right there. But as you see, I'm in the process of weathering it. This side right here is just paint, and this side's chalk, and obviously it's not done yet, but that's the basic idea so far. Got a lot of work ahead of me with this one. My basic plan is just to fade it just a very little bit, and you know, do some rust around the doors, you know, where it opens, some rust streaks right there on the door, where it streaks down from the rust and that, and maybe a little rust here on the logo where it door scrapes and then it runs down after the years of working. So, and then the run up wash up from all the grease on the trucks and stuff, all that stuff. So it's not going to be too rusty, but it's not going to be clean. And I plan to do a little bit of graffiti on one side. I don't want to do graffiti on both, just one side I'll do graffiti. So I'll keep you guys updated on that stuff. And here's the trucks it came with. And comes with its own weight. Gotta add the weight to it. The side handrails. These are gonna put on. And then all the little details and stuff. So that'd be cool. But that's about it on this layout update. So I got one more thing to show you. I'm working on this right now. This is just a piece of track that I'm working on. And what I plan to do is just put dirt all over it and make it look like a siding. Put some black dirt in it and stuff. And this will be my car track. For when I weather cars, I'll put it on that, put it out in the grass, and take pictures with it. So It's not done yet. I gotta add some more grass to it. And put some dirt on this side, obviously. And then that'll be done. And that'll look good too. And I'll weather this and weather the track a little bit. So, be real cool. Yep. I have another plan that I want to do. I want to get a BNSF Heritage 1 paint scheme, SD40-2. And I want to patch it out to Furex just like I did this one. I'm looking to get a Kato model. And obviously I'll get a lighter orange and patch it out. And then I'll do the same thing, keep the number and put the Furex underneath. And that'll look really cool. And it'll run really good with that one too. So, that'll be pretty cool once I get that. But that'll be a while. But, unless I can find another dummy unit with the BNSF Heritage 1 paint scheme, then I don't have any plans to get the Kato anytime soon, because that's a lot of money. Close to 100 to 160, depending on what I want. So, but I probably won't be doing too much more work on the layout, because I plan on buying a bunch of grain facilities. I plan on buying 2 ADM grain silos and building. So that's $60 right there for those two. I plan on buying 2 Model Power unloading grain silos, which is probably $40 right there. And then I plan on getting the surge bins, which is probably going to run me about $30-$35. And then the grain storage bins, which would probably be $20 a piece. So that's another $40. And then the trucks and all that stuff. So, and that'll be for the club layout. And my next coming layout updates will be mainly on those grain buildings. So, but I do plan to do some work on it. Probably do a lot of more scenery work over here, finish painting and put dirt down all around here and stuff, and try and finish up this area over here. So, because pretty much I'm just going to lay dirt down across this whole thing, you know, because I don't want to, that's pretty much all it is. Black dirt, you know, so that'd be cool. So there you guys go. If you liked it, so tell me what you think, and I'll keep you guys updated on these cars.